Hi, I'm Damon Smith, Extension Field Crops Pathologist for the University of Wisconsin-Madison. Today we're standing in a soybean field in Arlington, Wisconsin, where there was a rye cover crop planted. And prior to planting of soybeans, that rye cover crop was terminated and these soybeans were planted in a 30-inch row spacing. This field does happen to have a history of white mold, and today we're actually seeing the signs and symptoms of that white mold situation here. So just to show you a little bit about white mold, here are the signs and symptoms. You can see the white cottony growth here. This is actually mycelium of the fungus. And then you can see actually here we've got the formation of survival structures. We call these sclerotia, and they resemble a rat dropping. If you look a little more closely, you'll notice that as the plant is being colonized by the fungus, the stems and branches are actually starting to turn a bleached yellow color. Okay. If we find a little more advanced symptom here, you'll see where this plant is actually pretty much dead at this point, and we split open the stem here, you'll actually see the sclerotia have formed internally inside the stem. And this is problematic at harvest time because when we run our combines through the field, we spread these sclerotia out as we combine. And these sclerotia can also get caught in combines. So that's a great way actually of spreading the fungus around. So it's very important to clean your combines between fields and be certain you're not spreading the sclerotia around to other fields that may not actually be infested. In terms of management, we usually recommend resistant varieties. However, resistance is what we term partial, so it's not perfect. You will indeed need to do other things, such as increase row spacing. If you're on a narrow row spacing, such as 7.5 or 15, it would help to go to a 30-inch row spacing. Also, dropping populations down to 140,000 at planting or a little less than that can also further reduce white mold severity. In addition to those things such as variety and cultural practices, the applications of fungicides can help. However, that window of opportunity would be at the start of flowering or the R1 growth stage, all the way on up to about the R3 growth stage or the beginning of the first pod formation. After that or before that window, we've got pretty good data to show that the efficacy of fungicides is not very good outside of that window. In terms of products, we have an extensive list of products on my website, badgercropdoc.com. You can also consult your local extension agent and also A3646, which is our Wisconsin field crops management guide.